And welcome back to my channel. Today I will be participating in the May I Scrap Lift You as well as Stash Dive Tuesday. And I will be scrap lifting Tisa Brown Creates. And for my stash dive, I am going to get into some really, really old papers from, I believe they're called Scrap Within Reach. I really liked the muted tones. And I'm also going to be using some paper from Sassafras Lass, which used to be a huge love of mine. And I am taking Tisa's layout, which I absolutely adore, and I am going to create a two-page layout. We were in Mexico in February, in the beginning of March, and we had an opportunity to do a lot of tours, and one of the tours stopped at this place where they were making mud bricks, and these people were incredible. They were making them by hand and just really hardworking people, and so I wanted to document that process. I took tons and tons of photos, and I was happy to be able to get a lot of them on here. And so what I'm doing is I'm just cutting out 6x6 squares, and then I am cutting the strips around it to mimic what Tisa had done on her layout. And so I'm just kind of adding in different colors. This one is the one from Sassafras Lass, which used to be one of my absolute favorite companies, and I'm so sad that they went out of business, but I think that's probably true of a lot of different companies from years ago in the scrapbook community. So I suppose this is my homage to some of these companies. So I really liked this paper, and I thought I could really use those strips and just add a little more interest to my layout. I like kind of mixing different patterns and colors, and this layout gave me an opportunity to do that without just completely overwhelming the layout. So I wanted to add just a little bit of visual interest. And so on the layout, the original layout, there was one larger photo, and then there were three smaller photos. And so what I'm doing now is I'm cutting down some of my pictures, and I'm going to put them on these Polaroid stickers. And this is also a huge stash dive. I have had this particular thing in my stash for probably forever. And I'm going to go ahead and use the rest of the Polaroid parts of that. And I think I'm left with maybe four square stickers. And I am going to do the unthinkable, and I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of it. So one thing out of my stash. And I don't know why I hadn't used it more before then. I really do enjoy it. And there were some words on the Polaroid part of the stickers, and I'm going to cover some of that up because it just didn't really apply, but I still wanted to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and stick all of these things down and just kind of get those squares on my layout. And if you don't have a lot of one piece of or one particular pattern paper, this is a great way to kind of stretch the use of it. It gives the impression that I have a lot of layers here, and obviously I don't, and the seams tend to go pretty well together, and so I'm not really worried about that. And if I was concerned about that, I could always put some embellishments over it. So I really encourage you that if you have not yet tried this technique, it's just a real fun way to do things. And gets rid of some paper scraps. It's a great way to use paper scraps. And yeah, just a lot of fun, just playing with some strips of paper. And I just think it gives such a fun look to it. And so now I'm going to go ahead and put my photos down. And I chose two of them that I really didn't feel I could cut down any smaller. That's kind of the entrance, I think, to one of the
ovens that they fire the bricks in. And it was just this really large yard, and I just couldn't believe that these people were doing this by hand. They had like a rectangular mold and were putting the mud in there. And apparently these adobe bricks are just really, really durable. And so it was such a cool process to see. And I'm kind of a nerd anyway, and so being able to learn about this process and see part of this culture was just really kind of fun. And so one thing that I did a little bit differently from the original layout is I am going to kind of put these overlapping with each other, and I'm going to put some in the top left and the others in the bottom right. And I'm just really happy with the way it turned out. I think the Polaroid look to it just really gave that extra little touch there. And so now I'm going to look through my embellishments. I've got my journaling on there. I think I'm going to actually pull the journaling up at one point and decide where I want to put it. But it always ends up back there. So now I'm just kind of working on my title, and this is another opportunity for me to dive into my stash. I have several sheets of letter stickers and such, and so it was fun to just pull out different fonts and colors and add that to my title. I think that mixed font, mixed color title just gives a lot of visual interest there. Yep, see, here I go. I put my journaling up there at the top. It is not going to stay there. Looking at it now, I think it probably could have stayed there, but I am going to go ahead and move that eventually. So now I'm just looking at some of my newer stash, and I have several things from Simple Stories that I'm going to add in there. I might have some P13 things that I'm just going to kind of layer up some words and other little ephemera. And one of the strips that I had left from the sassafras paper had kind of a stitched look to it, and I thought that worked really well with the colors and added just a little bit more visual interest to that more plain textured paper. And so, a funny thing, there's one little house down there, and I originally had two houses pulled out, and I could not, for the life of me, find the other house. So I can't remember if it finally made it onto the final layout, but I looked everywhere for it, and it wasn't until I finished up the layout that I finally found it. So yeah, I think that's actually just as as common as losing the tape and scissors when you're wrapping presents. That is just something that I do. Now I will mention, if you hadn't noticed that, when I pulled up the journaling, I did rip my paper just a little bit, and so I'm going to go ahead and add a few things over in that corner just to cover that up. And I have some really cute little wood words that I wanted to put in there, and I'm just kind of looking to see what else I want to do to complete those embellishment clusters. This was just kind of a fun layout to do and to embellish. I'm just throwing on a few things here and there, some butterflies, and just trimming off the edges, and that's going to be about it. There is that second house, by the way. And so, thanks again for stopping by my channel. I hope that you get a chance to hop along with not only the May I Scrap Lift You crew, but also the Stash Dive Tuesday crew as well. I will have links to their channels as well as the link to where you can find Tisa's original layout that I scrap lifted. Thanks again. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I would really encourage you to do that. I've got a lot of videos coming up, and I would love to have you hanging out with us. Take care, everyone, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.